Good evening, dear students. Today in this video, you will get information pertaining to vapor power cycles or gas power cycles, which is prescribed in the curriculum of applied thermodynamics. Anyhow, in the first two modules of applied thermodynamics, you have come across the two prominent modules, that is air standard cycles and gas turbines. On studying those two modules, you will not find any difficulty in understanding vapor power cycles. Vapor power cycles can also be referred to as gas power cycles. In the earlier curriculum, it was referred to as vapor power cycles, but in this new scheme, it has been prescribed as gas power cycles. Friends, initially, to know about a strong introduction about vapor power cycles or gas power cycles, we should know the technological relevance properly. Anyhow, in the course applied thermodynamics, every module is pertaining to application, a strong or solid application. Likewise, we should know the technological relevance of vapor or gas power cycles. Where exactly is this predominantly used or employed? Friends, just remember the principle of operation of a thermal power plant or a steam power plant. When you visit a typical thermal power station, you will get to understand the complete quintessence of engineering thermodynamics. Okay? So each and every thermodynamic component you will see to in the thermal power station or a steam power station. Okay, what is the strong prerequisite? Friends, to know the strong basics of vapor power cycles, as I said, one has to visit a thermal power station. In a thermal power station, very commonly, in order to operate, what is the type of fuel used? You all aware that we will be using normally coal, pulverized coal. There are many components festooned in a thermal power station. As in the case of a human body, heart is very important. Okay? So, if you have heart, you can show or exhibit your art. Likewise, in a thermal power station, which is the heart, it is invariably boiler. Please bear in mind, very closely to the high pressure boiler, you can find water treatment plant. Also, in a power station, you find a turbine. So, which are the very, very commonly components equipped in a thermal power station? It is a pulverizing unit, then boiler, combustion chamber, water treatment plant, then powerhouse. But in comprehending the essence of vapor or gas power cycles, we should be aware of four strong components: boiler, condenser, then it is a water treatment plant, and finally the steam generating unit. So, on what thermodynamic cycles this thermal power station or steam power station work? Friends, while learning heat engines, did you not come across a very prominent thermodynamic cycle? It is Carnot cycle. Have you not come across? Yes. Wherever you go, whatever you do in thermodynamics, very frequently learned thermodynamic cycle is Carnot cycle. Even in the comprehension of vapor or gas power cycles, one will find Carnot cycle. Friends, the beginning of vapor power cycles is the learning of Carnot cycle. How to study? How exactly we can get the information about vapor power cycles? Initially, study the flow process and temperature entropy plot of ideal Carnot cycle. Properly draw the flow diagram. You know that boiler is very important. Boiler and condensing units are very important. You know that from the water treatment plant, you will perceive hard water directly into a high pressure boiler. So behind the boiler or below the bottom portion of the boiler, you find a combustion chamber. The pulverized coal will be completely achieving combustion phenomenon later on in a boiler, high pressure is developed. So friends, high pressure boiler with a combustion chamber are very important. So in a flow process or a flow diagram, the incorporation of boiler and condensing units are very important. Okay, then naturally heating unit is there and condensing unit will be there. Heat addition, heat rejection takes place. So in the temperature entropy plot, make sure that you clearly depict the flow processes very meticulously. So this is what the ideal Carnot cycle, what you will be learning in vapor power cycles. This is the beginning. All right, but normally to understand the complete essence of vapor power cycles, one should be well acquainted with Rankine cycle. So that is very important. In order to know the actuality of a thermal power station, the principle is very important. How one can understand the principle? Only when you come across the comprehension of Rankine cycle. Children, ideal Carnot cycle, as clearly suggests, it is basically theoretical by nature. So practically, we may not be in a position to employ or use for any other principle. Ideal Carnot cycle, it is just a concept. Based on ideal Carnot cycle, one can conceptually understand the principle of operation of a power station by employing Rankine cycle. What exactly the meaning of this? Friends, you know that in 1820, William Macon Rankine, a very prominent thermodynamicist, he had a motive in developing a model for a power station. In order to understand that particular model, he could write the flow diagram and temperature entropy plot. In the case of temperature entropy plot, one can clearly understand what exactly the terms boiler pressure and condenser pressure. Say any flow diagram in vapor power cycle you take up, the incorporation of boiler and condenser are very important. Okay, so in every thermodynamic cycle, in the case of vapor power cycle, please make sure that you learn the calculation of thermal efficiency of that power plant, next calculation of work ratio and specific fuel consumption. In the lecture notes, one can clearly understand these concepts without any hesitation or fear. That I can promise. Okay. So after learning ideal Carnot cycle, make sure that you can learn or understand Rankine cycle. All right. So next, what should be the operation? After comprehending Rankine cycle, please study reheat cycle. In thermodynamics, preheating, reheating are very essential. In the case of power stations, reheating is very important. Anyhow, while learning gas turbines, one of the prominent methods to improve thermal efficiency of gas turbine is reheating plant. Okay, so that reheating unit has the potential to improve thermal efficiency of turbines. Likewise, in the case of vapor power cycles also, reheat unit is very important. Any thermodynamic cycle you take up, please bear in mind what are the two components very important: boiler, condenser. Okay, so heating process, cooling processes are very essential in the case of thermodynamics. Likewise, one can clearly understand the flow diagram and temperature entropy plot in the case of reheat cycle. So the first three cycles, Carnot, next comes Rankine, reheat. All right, is there any other thermodynamic cycle? Yes, we have something called regenerative cycle. Okay, three R's you have to remember. Okay, so what are those three R's? One is Rankine, the second one is reheat, the third R is regenerative. Okay, so please bear that in mind. In learning air standard cycles, five cycles, Carnot, next comes Otto, diesel dual combustion, finally it is Stirling. But here you will be coming across three R's: reheat, Rankine, regenerative. Is this regenerative cycle already learnt? Yes, friends. You just remember air standard cycles, whatever we have learnt in the course, applied thermodynamics. What is that regenerative cycle? Regenerative cycle meaning what? Stirling cycle. Even though that Stirling cycle is obsolete, the use of heat exchanger is very important. Okay, so what is the close context for an heat exchanger? It is a regenerator. Repetitive generation of heat takes place. So even in the case of vapor power cycles or gas power cycles, regenerative cycle is important. Okay, so regenerative, what is that? Repetitive generation of heat takes place. That means to say you will be employing with heat exchanger. So if you understand these clauses very meticulously, you will be in a position to take up any numerical problem effortlessly. Okay, so what are the four prominent vapor power cycles we need to come across? The first one, it is very conceptual, that is ideal Carnot cycle. But practically based cycles are what? Number one is Rankine, purely based on the operation of a thermal power station or a plant. The next one is reheat. The third one is regenerative. Okay. So for every cycle, please practice the flow diagram and temperature entropy plot. Clearly depict the salient points indicating the thermodynamic processes. Also, please bear in mind, for every cycle, you have to calculate thermal efficiency, work ratio, and specific fuel consumption. But what is the tip to solve any problem on vapor power cycles? Is there any suggestive tip? Yes, friends. In the previous videos also, it has been meticulously mentioned, for solving any problem on vapor power cycles, one has to use thermodynamic data handbook. Kindly practice in seeing to the tables, also charts in thermodynamic data handbook. Okay, so you can solve any problem by just employing the tabular method, or directly by using Mollier diagram, one can solve it. Okay, so for any problem, you have to initially tabulate the values of enthalpy, entropy, specific volume, and other things. Okay, then you will be in a position to calculate thermal efficiency, work ratio, and specific fuel consumption. The same procedure is employable for all cycles. Okay, so for any problem, make sure that you draw the flow diagram and temperature entropy plot. Once when this is done, 30 to 60% of the burden will be reduced. Okay, also please practice in seeing to the thermodynamic data handbook. All right, sometimes the problems may be slightly tricky. They'll not be asking directly on Rankine cycle, reheat cycle, or regenerative cycle. Independently, they may not ask. They may ask in combination. Okay, Rankine, reheat, then reheat, regenerative. The amalgam of thermodynamic cycles, they will ask. Okay, for any problem, what is the suggestive tip? Please follow the flow diagram and temperature entropy plot. Once when this is done, from the thermodynamic data handbook or charts, you can tabulate the values of enthalpy, entropy. use the pertinent formulae, you can solve it. Anyhow, in the lecture notes, everything has been shared to all students. Please listen to this video. You will get every information. Okay? So, this is all about the epigrammatic overview or summary of vapor part cycles. Okay? For your benefit, let me quickly summarize the information. So, what is the procedure for learning vapor part cycles or gas part cycles? Initially, you should have a strong introduction. What exactly the relevance of vapor part cycles? As suggested or mentioned, it will be very much relying on what? The operation of a thermal power station. Okay? So, if this is clear to any student, he or she will be in a position to understand the analytical aspects very meticulously. Okay? Later on, to learn the flow diagrams and TS plots for the pertinent cycles, which are all the thermodynamic cycles one has to practice, ideal Carnot cycle, next is Rankine, reheat, regenerative. 3 hours you have to practice, very important, and combination they will ask. Okay, Rankine, reheat, reheat, regenerative. So, reheat, regenerative, it is very practical by nature. Whatever flow diagrams you write for Rankine, reheat, reheat, regenerative, they are the juxtaposed TS plots. Okay, in single TS plot, two cycles will be encumbered. So, please bear in mind. Also, to solve any problem, as clearly mentioned, employing data handbook is very important. Finally, what sort of problems we need to take up? As clearly mentioned, for any thermodynamic cycle, one has to learn the calculation of thermal efficiency, work ratio, and specific fuel consumption. Okay? By listening to this, I can promise that any numerical problem of any nature, you can solve. This is all about the epigrammatic review of vapor power cycles. Listen to this and carefully understand the concepts. Thank you all. Good luck.